So just about to get underway now with this final game of this Thursday evening at the Scottish Open Grand Prix between Martin Campbell and Patrick Machugh of Scotland and Marcus Ellis and Chris Langridge of England. Campbell and Machugh, recent winners of the Hungarian Open, of course, will be relishing this chance to get at the second seats. But I think it's a tough match for them. Marcus Ellis and Chris Langridge, strong pair. So it'll be interesting to see how the first half of this game unfolds, whether the Scots can get into it, or whether the English pair are just too strong and too quick for them. So just about ready to go. Final practice serves. Be happy with that. Interception from Martin there in midcourt. Puts the shuttle away, takes the first point. Good solid hit from Martin, aided by net cord. See in the top left hand corner of your screen that Robert Blair has come straight off his game and gone into the coaching chair to give the boys a helping hand. Return. Ellis and Langridge, pretty experienced pair now, been out on the circuit for a while. All square after these early exchanges, 4-all. good communication between the English pair. They do speak to each other quite frequently. And they do have a good understanding. It's not very easy to find gaps in their partnership. Good rally, interrupted at the end there as Marcus tried to rush off and change a racket. We've seen much more play in this match, either straight down the channels or into the middle of the court than we saw in the last match. Unorthodox return off that flick there from Chris Langridge, but they take the point. Short lift, but well put away by Patrick Machugh. Brings them back even at 8th hole. Just lifted a bit too long by Martin there. Well, it's another good rally there. Just the final smash netted by Marcus Ellis. Nothing in this match. 9-all. I think the Scottish bench will be happier about that than the English one at this stage. Player is being allowed a break there after it was quite a lengthy rally for men's doubles. Flick serve there of Marcus Ellis, called fault again, and that allows the Scots to go into the interval 11-10 ahead. And you're seeing the Scottish coaching team on the screen, but I think Jakob Hoy is questioning why that serve was a flick serve at that point on the English side of the net. I think I'd be slightly disappointed, Hoy, with the performance so far of the English pair, considering where they are in the pecking order of men's doubles badminton. I'm sure he would have expected them to have a clear lead at this stage, not to be trailing by a point. So we'll see what happens now in the second half of this first game. No, they're definitely not playing their best at the moment, Langridge and Ellis. It's short out of defence, and I've seen them play with superb defence in the past. Last match on in the hall, of course, after 9:30 at night, and a thinning crowd. I suppose it's not easy to get yourself fully motivated for a match that You know when you go on, you're expected to win. Your opponent's playing well, put you under some pressure. Scottish pair need to just try and make them play every shuttle, cut out the unforced errors, keep the pressure on them, and see what happens. And it's wide again. Ellis refusing the instruction of the umpire here and handing over rackets for restring in the middle of the game. Coach isn't going to take them anywhere just now. Slightly unlucky. Good idea for Martin. Knock off straight down the middle, almost unreturnable from the position Ellis was in, but it was just long. Resolute defence there from Martin Campbell, produces the error. Brings the Scots back to within 2 points. Scott's just showing a little irritation at the amount of discussion going on between the English pair between points here. I've been two or three excellent rallies in this game, but a lot of scrappy stuff in between. Neither pair really flowing at the moment. Another scrappy rally brings up game point for Ellis and Langridge 2016. Failed to take it at the first opportunity. Still game point, 17-20. Whole court exposed, and they take it at the second time of asking. 21-17. Ellis Langridge going with a one game lead. We'll be back just after this interval. So, just about ready now to get this second game underway. Langridge serving to Campbell. A good opening rally taken by the Scots. Martin puts the shuttle away at the feet of Marcus Ellis. A return there from Patrick. Missed time, shot straight up. Allowed Marcus to put it onto the floor. Good again from Martin. Still no real rhythm that I can see on the English side of the net. Very disjointed play. Quite a lot of unforced errors from them. Just not the sort of mistake you expect to see from a pair of their standing. Yeah, that's good. Martin just taking the pace off. Soft shot, Patrick able to put it away. So pretty much the same pattern as the first set, neck and neck in these early stages. Short second lift there, given the opportunity for the shuttle to be put away. Apologies there from Chris Langridge to Patrick Machugh as he fired the shuttle straight back at a prostrate Machugh, but nothing wrong with that. Right shot in the circumstances. Yeah, nice shot, Martin Campbell. Tastes completely off that. Oh, well, that's another very good rally, a lot of variation there. Such a shame that Martin left that shot clearly inside the line. And it takes the English pair to 8-6. It's the third or fourth time I've noticed that the English pair are not quite sure which one of them is due to serve or which side to serve from. It's quite unusual that in men's doubles. Usually quite focused on where you should be. Good play again from Martin. Some indecision there. Scott's clash of rackets, not quite sure who was going to take it. Resulted in the shorter lift and the kill. still fighting hard. Machugh and Campbell to stay in the second set, just 1 point adrift. And that's gone wide. So again, apologies that we can't bring you any statistics. I don't know the head-to-heads between these two, and I'm not confident enough of what I think of the world rankings to say them over the air. But unfortunately, we don't have any computers here for me to access tournament software. So after a lengthy mopping up delay, we have 1 point to take the English into an 11-9 lead at the interval, and we're on to another break. There seems to be just slightly more sense of purpose in the English play since the interval. Taking the next 2 points. Quite aggressive attacking play. 4 points in a row, takes them up to 15. Well, the Scots really need to stop this run now if they have to have any hope of getting back into the second game. It's already a 7-point lead. And they've done just that. Drawing ever nearer the finishing line now, 7-point lead re-established, 17-10. That's a good interception there. Marcus Ellis very quick to get his racket back up. Nice cut cross smash there. Brings them up to 19. Well, the big difference in the interval has been a lot fewer unforced errors from the English pair. One there from Chris Langridge gives the Scots a lifeline, 11-19. Not taken though. So match point. Oh, brave to leave that. Didn't look very far away. And that one's out, though. So they take it at the second time of asking. Match to Ellis and Langridge, 21-17. 21-12. And that's the final match this evening. Look forward to quarterfinals and semi-finals tomorrow, Saturday. So if you can get along to the Emirates Arena in Glasgow, please come and join us. If not, keep watching and listening online. Look forward to seeing you and hearing from you then.